I'm Corbett Wall with DV Auction, here with your feeder flash for Thursday, September the 3rd, brought to you by RioMax, a highly concentrated, low consumption, low cost per head, per day, mineral. Feed the bugs in the rumen with RioMax. It's available now in combo cubes. For more information, go to RioMax.net and sign up for a chance to win a four-wheeler there. The fats are falling. Your fats traded again on Wednesday and traded another dollar lower for the most part than they did earlier in the week, and we're just losing ground like crazy in our fat cattle market. Be lucky to hold them over a dollar this month, which I think most people are thinking we probably give up on that. But everything was lower. Your box beef cutout values, they're seasonally lower now. We've got our feeder cattle have been quite a bit lower this week, and in most of our sales, especially in the southern plains. Get up in the northern plains up there with the farmer feeders, where they're the most active and hasn't been quite so much lower. The board was down pretty handy on Wednesday, although it was down hard early and then come back, and we're getting some volatility again. And everybody's kind of looking to the board for direction because nobody really knows what this thing's going to do. And the only thing the board is reacting to is technicals. Everybody's studying the charts and looking at things and trying to get an idea of what's going on there. And you guys know that I don't think a whole lot of the charts, but if you've got nothing to go on, you've got to look somewhere. And so a lot of these analysts are looking at the charts and they're seeing double bottoms and things like that are giving them encouragement that this thing's going to rally back again. But fundamentally, there's just nothing really there to rally on. But we're still going to have a good crop. I know we had another outfit that gave their analysis of the yields, and they said that they weren't going to be quite as good as what they were thinking, but that's not the USDA. That's just a Chicago outfit there. We saw a minimal amount of higher market in your grains because of that, but your grains aren't doing a whole lot. They bounced up there quite a bit after the big windstorm that they had up in Iowa, and they kind of held that level. But tell you what, we're just kind of looking for a direction right here to go. Nobody can get overly excited about the market regaining anything, but at the same time, there's no reason for it to go any lower. We still got outstanding demand export and in the retail counter. What we need is for these Democratic officials that have gotten power hungry over these COVID restrictions, we need them to open us back up. We need to get these restaurants back open at full capacity. We need to get events going again where people are cooking out and grilling. What are we going to do without our tailgating at the football games if we're going to be cut down so much, if at all, if anybody watching the games, They cook a lot of beef out there in those parking lots sometime. But that's the main thing we need. If we could get our food service going back again, I think we've got some room for a rally. But it doesn't seem like that anybody's getting excited about that, even though earlier in the week we found out that indeed not most of those people that are dying of COVID are not just dying of COVID. In fact, only 6% of all the people that's died of COVID-related sickness, and there's been like 185,000 of them in the United States, only 6% of them died of just COVID. The other ones had another disease or condition that was causing that. So, this is ridiculous. We've got to get this thing open back up again, and everybody says November the 3rd it's going to magically heal up. I hope it does. I wish it would sooner than that. But let's look at the board on Wednesday. October live cattle down a buck at 104.47. December was down 70 cents at 108.45. Going out from there, and your live cattle contracts were down 45 cents to down 70 cents, so pretty consistent. Feeder cattle contract September was down $1.42 at 138.70. October down $1.20 at 139.45. You're going out from there. It was mostly lower except for the last traded month was up 50 cents on your August 2021. Not sure where that came from, but your rest of your contracts out front were down with the most at 117. Fat cattle trade continued on Wednesday. A little bit of trade everywhere. Pretty much cleaned up in Texas, though. Everybody, when they got that $1.04 earlier in the week, pretty much everybody in Texas sold. And I told you that they were doing a pretty good job getting things sold because it's just been 2 or 3 weeks ago and everybody said they were really backed up with heavy cattle. So they've been aggressive down in Texas selling cattle. You look at the confirmed sales on Wednesday, Iowa had 3,700 confirmed from 102 to 105 live and 162 to 163 dressed. That's about steady with where they were at. Nebraska, 5,900, 102 to 103, and it's mostly 103 guys now and 162 to 163 dressed. Kansas, buck lower, 5,500 head confirmed. Mostly at 103, but they had some 101 even and some 102 and just about 400 head in Texas at 103. Those would be a buck lower than just earlier in the week. Box beef cutout values were lower. Choice cuts 227.58 down 76. Selects 213.82 down 93 cents. Your slaughter's keeping up about where it ought to be. So you get your feeder cattle market, your real-time index on DV Auction. Late in the day on Wednesday at 138.98, down 42 cents. So it continues to drift lower. Look at your big high volume sales. OKC West, El Reno, Oklahoma, 5,000 head there. And they had all the cattle on Wednesday. They got a real light calf run because they don't do near enough fall calving in that part of the country. But you look at your prices, your trends were mostly $3 to $6 lower on everything, except for your bigger steers, and where that's coming from, I don't know. Your bigger steers weighing over 800 pounds were actually steady to a buck higher. They sold the heck out of their big steers, and that was a big percentage of their run. So they actually had a really good sale in El Reno. And some of the other sales around there in the Southern Plains and in Central Oklahoma going to be kind of jealous because they weren't able to hold that on anything. But pretty good cutting on your big feeder cattle. And the heifers weighing over eight were only $1 to $2 lower, so that wasn't too bad. The few calves they had had a lower undertone on them. But talking about how well those steers sold went over eight, check out this best quote. They had 53 head, 841-pound steers, El Reno, Oklahoma, at 143 and a quarter. How about winter livestock, Dodge City, Kansas, only about 1,500 head. It was mostly $2 to $5 lower. They had Customer Appreciation Day, St. Joe Stockyards, 2,200 head there. Market was kind of uneven. It was lighter on the peewee calves. It was pretty decent on your middleweight feeding type calves and lower on your bigger feeders. But tell you what, they have some stick-out sales once in a while. How about 63 head of black heifers, weighed 609 at 155 and a quarter. Wow. I try to give you guys as much cross-reference across what's going on in your feeder cattle. How about some Holstein steers? Springfield Livestock Marketing Center. It's a DV auction yard there. And I tell you what, Springfield, Missouri has always been the Holstein steer capital of the world. They used to raise a lot. They used to dairy a lot in that country before California took it over, and now it's moved into New Mexico and all over the place, you know. But back when people used to milk 200 or 300 cows instead of 2,000 or 3,000, they did a lot of dairying in southern Missouri. And then whenever they pushed them out of that, a lot of guys were still raising dairy heifers in that part of the country. Well, it got to be kind of a big place to sell and raise and feed Holstein steers. But you just don't see that much of that anymore, you know. Now that we got sex semen and you know, it may be a time when you got to go to a zoo to see a Holstein steer. But and most of the ones that are available out of the big dairies, they send them to Arizona or somewhere to feed them. But Springfield Livestock Marketing Center can still sell Holstein steers. On Wednesday, they had 53 head, weighed 1,011 pounds at 95 and a dime. That's a pretty good quote for Holstein steers, guys. But the best quotes that I saw anywhere come out of Green City Livestock Marketing, Green City, Missouri. That's North Central Missouri up there in the Green Hills there. That's a DV auction market. You can view and bid that sale every Wednesday right there. But look at all these impressive loads of steers that they had there. Man, they had a heck of a good sale, over 3,000 head altogether. But look at these Satman cattle, the last ones quoted there, 59 head, 893-pound steers, bring $145 to a Northern Iowa farmer feeder. And that's your feeder flash for Thursday.